All right, so in this video, we're going to be going over data entry and data management. We'll go from an Excel file to an SPSS data file. We'll make variable and value labels. We'll recode some values, and we'll make some composite scores. So first thing we got to do is take this Excel file and turn it into an SPSS data file. And there's two ways to do that. First way is simply just copy and pasting all of our data into SPSS. So we go over to our SPSS new data file, data view, and we'll just paste everything in. The problem with doing that is it creates some really messy variable names that we have to go back and relabel. So let's go ahead and do that. Go to variable view, and let's figure out what those variable names were. So we start at gender, race, income. And starting at this variable, we go to question 1 pretest, on to question 10 pretest, and then we start at post-test. So let's just label these pre-1, pre-2, on until pre-10. And then we start at post. All right, so that was one way to get our data into SPSS. The second way is if you have your Excel file on the desktop or wherever it is it's located, if you right-click it, and go to where it says open with, you'll have some options there. And if SPSS does not show up, you'll want to click the button that says choose default program. And you should have something like this. It may not contain SPSS there. So you want to unclick this box, but you also want to hit browse. And then you'll find your SPSS file. It's probably in program files under SPSS. And you'll want to say that you want to open it with this SPSS file. Now, doing so, we'll open it like this. It'll say it's already in use, but you'll want to open it anyways because we want to keep going. So we say yes. So we get to here, and it says this. It says read variable names from the first row of data. And if you remember, these are our variable names, and this is the first row. So we do want this. And it asks which sheet to work from, and this is worksheet 1, and that's fine. And the rest you can leave as is. So basically default just hit OK. This brings up a new SPSS window, and we see that we have our variable labels here already. And for the longer ones, as you can see, question 1 pretest, it used to have those spaces, but in a variable name, you cannot use spaces. So it smushed it all together in the variable label. It gave us our nice, neat labels. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to make variable and value labels. So for race, we can see we've got white, Hispanic, Asian, black, and for gender we got male and female. So let's start out by doing just an auto recode. And that will automatically recode our male and female and white, Hispanic, Asian, black into numbers that end up being somewhat easier to use. So we go to transform and we hit the button that says automatic recode. We take our variables gender and race, put them over here, and we need to make new names for them. So we'll call this gender recode. Add new name, race, race recode. Add new name. Now we want to treat blank string values as user missing. This is very important because sometimes when you have something missing in Excel under here, let's say this one was blank, then it would treat that as a zero. And we don't want it as a zero, we want it as missing because it would be technically missing. So we'll leave it as that and we'll make sure that's clicked. And we'll hit OK. And now it ran it so that we have our new values. This is the output window. So our old value were female and male. Our new values for gender recode are 1 and 2, and our value labels are female and male. And the same thing goes for our race. So we go back to our data. Make sure this is the right one. Back to our data, and we see here gender recode, race recode. One is female, two is male. One is Asian, black, Hispanic, white, other, and white. And now let's give these variables some labels because we don't want to have it pop up as gender recode when we're doing any analyses. So we'll just name this gender and this race. Now income. Income, we can see our numeric numbers already. And let's say we knew from our survey instrument that 1 represents 50,000 or less. And 2 represents 50,000 to 100,000. 3 was 100 to 200. 4 was 200. 500, and let's say 5 is 1 million over, or 500 plus. All right, so we want to get these labels. So we go over here to values. We say in value 1 is less than 50,000. Value 2 is 50,000 to 100. 3, 100,000 to 200,000, 4, 200,000 to 500,000, and 5 over 500,000. Alright, so now that we have our variable value labels here, let's run some frequencies to make sure everything looks right. You always want to run frequencies whenever you're using any new values from Excel or anything, just to double check yourself. So we'll go to frequencies. Let's look at income, gender, and race to make sure there are no surprises. Let me look at our output. We've got frequency tables here. As you see, we've got less than 50, got 24, so we've got our frequencies tables here. But if we look, we have a value of 11. Now that may have been due to an entry error, or it may be just something is wrong here. Maybe someone hit 1-1 instead of 1. So we want to correct that. We don't want that in there. That could really bias the results. So we look at our data view. We go to income. And let's find that 11. There's two ways to find it. Since we know it's one of the highest numbers, we can right click and say sort descending, or we can just leave it as it is and find it. So we have a small data set and here it is. So since we are not sure what happened to that 11, whether it was 1-1 or just some mistake, it's better to just delete it. If you have too many of these sort of errors, you might want to think about how they were an error. Maybe they were double ones. Maybe you had 3-3, 2-2, and a 1-1. Then it might be more logical to replace it. But since we have a good amount of participants, it's better and advised to delete it. All right, so now that we've removed the mistake, outlier, what have you, we have some other stuff to do. Let's recheck everything to make sure everything is in line. That's good. female, male, and those are good. So let's go back to our data, and we want to create some composite scores. We want to do a sum of all our question pretests and our question post-tests. However, as you can see, these have numbers, however, these are still labels. Now, we know that 1 is strongly disagree, 2 is disagree, 3 is neutral, etc. However, if we were to do something like an automatic recode for this, it would start assigning values based on the alphabet, not based on what we know is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we're going to have to manually recode these. So what we want to do is transform into different variables. Go down here. We'll select all of our post-test questions since they're all labeled the same. And we'll make some new labels for them. Q1 post, Q2 post, alright, so now we want to assign the old and new values. The first value would be strongly disagree, assigned to 1. Disagree is assigned to 2. Neutral is assigned to 3. Agree is assigned to 4. And strongly agree is assigned to 5. So we'll hit continue. And we want to just hit OK. And go ahead and hit OK there if that comes up. Now, we have our new recodes. As you can see, we have numbers here. Now, let's do a little descriptive statistics of frequencies to make sure everything looks in line again. So we'll do all of the post-tests. Got 3, 4s, and 5s for all of these. We have no missings, which are good. So everything transferred over correctly. All right, so now that we've got that out of the way, let's make some composite scores. So how to do that? So we go to transform, compute variable. And we want to make a pretest score. So pretest is our variable label. And there's two ways to do this. One is to simply say question 1 pretest plus, question 2 pretest plus, etc., etc. The other solution is to say we want to do the sum of all these values separated by commas. Now, along with this, since we know that we want to add this question all the way to this question, these 10 in a row questions, there's a shortcut we can do. And it involves using a to, typing TO. So we want sum question 1 pretest space capital TO space question 10 pretest. Close the parenthesis and we'll hit OK. And as you can see, it ran. So we'll go down here and we have pretest scores now. So now we do the same thing for post test. So we say post-test equals, and if you remember, we recoded these, and the reason we recoded these is because we can't take the sum of a word. So we recoded them into numbers. We said Q1 post, Q2, and we'll just do it this way, just to make it, just to show both. 8, 9, and 10. Close our parentheses, hit OK. And now we've got our post-test scores. And there we go. That's it.